Hi, my name is Chris White with Corson Fire and Security. So CO2 systems, you're going to find more of the manufacturing type environments, flammable storage room, oil quench type rooms, turbines or generators, anywhere where high fire, steel mills, those type of things is where you're going to generally see either a low pressure or high pressure CO2 type system. Again, we talked about design concentration and the way CO2 discharges by oxygen depletion. And because of that, CO2 now is going to require actually life safety devices. One of the first ones we're going to talk about is a pneumatic timer. So generally these are going to be 30 or 60 seconds. Your system is going to discharge, it's going to run through the pneumatic timer, and once it runs through the pneumatic timer, then it will allow the system to actually discharge, just to ensure that personnel can properly evacuate the area. The next life safety device that we want to discuss is the actual pneumatic siren. This siren will actually activate even before the system discharges. It's still running through the pneumatic timer. This siren's activated to ensure that personnel knows the system is activated and again can evacuate in a safe manner. The next life safety device we want to speak of is a supervised lockout valve. Whenever general maintenance is being performed, supervised lockout valve really should be activated in the event an inadvertent CO2 discharge. With the valve closed, CO2 wouldn't be able to discharge. The pneumatic siren would still activate, but CO2 would not be discharging out of the nozzles into the area. And the very last safety device we want to speak of is the pneumatic odorizer. It has a wintergreen smell. And if you happen to be walking in an area because CO2 is colorless, odorless, leaves no residue, you may not realize you're in a CO2 environment. You smell wintergreen, that's a key indication to safely get out and evacuate the area. These are life safety devices that could be required depending on your type of occupancy for the CO2 system being protected.